Hello, all greetings. This is Gilles. Welcome, my friends. I wanted to come back and discuss, continue the discussion about the spiritual ideas, science, philosophy. I'm going to pull a few cards first to create an oracle, to see a little bit on three levels, on general personal level, spiritual level, then on professional level. And a whole bunch of cards. And finally about more romantic aspect, and so let's see what the Voyager cards, we use that. It's just a mirror, right? It is just for entertainment purposes, but usually the tarot brings back to the forefront of consciousness situations that are already present. On a general level, the highest wisdom is equilibrium, it is balance, it is love, it is sharing. What we need to understand is sorrow. We have to let go of sorrow, we have to accept the sorrow, but not to dwell on it, not to bring back all the wounds into our presence. We need to make whole the wounds. What we need to do is fulfillment, is to make our dream come true, is to celebrate, is to be happy, is to celebrate the new cycle. And the outcome is the hangman, is everything is stuck, so there is need for letting go of those things that need to be let go. So that's very in essence, so that we can be free. Once we let go, we can be free. On a more professional level, the highest wisdom comes from the player, which means to have fun, to enjoy, to play, to be the child of the world, to enjoy ourselves. For the more we put joy into our work, the more successful we'll become. What we need to understand is compassion, is how to do good to ourselves, it is how to be good to ourselves and to be kind to others, to assist others, to work in a synergetic process with the world around us. What we need to do is the devil's play. It is the card of materialism, but it means not to let anybody demonize you or not to be in judgment of yourself. It's also to elevate ourselves above the ego, for the ego will keep us entrapped. I'm going to discuss this idea of fear and the illusions of fear. Fear is connected to the ego. And the outcome is the regenerator. So there's going to be new sources that will come about in professional circle, new opportunities, new job, new financial income. All those things are in the works. And so we need to blend in, and on the romantic level, the highest wisdom is breakthrough. It's like nice. It's a volcano. It's like a breakthrough. Something that breaks through. There is something at some point. There is some the new opportunities. Once again, something that accumulated our process. We are attracting the right person, and we're finding this point of communion, a new level of integration in relationship. What we need to understand is the seer, to be able to trust in the vision, to trust in our intuition, to be very intuitive and powerful within holding this light. What we need to do is anger. For anger, it is normal to be angry about many things, but we want to canalize our anger and we want to breathe. When something makes you angry, breathe three times to find the serenity and peace within yourself, and then you can send the light to balance out. Because if somebody makes you angry, it's because there is something that's misaligned that's coming to you or come from within that's misaligned. So it's about bringing back the harmony, but not to react from an ego perspective of conflict. Like somebody sends you negative energy, you're going to send back negative energy, and this person's going to send back negative energy. So it's about any negative energy, you send positive energy back, and then it stops the conflict. And the anger finds a level of purity in the expression of anger, and the outcome is the star. For the star is the dream come true, but it's also the inaccessible. So here it is the goddess Kuan Yin. It's about following. It talks about angelic assistance, angelic guidance, protection. It speaks about making our dreams come true, our wish come true, and so many things will be possible. Although there is a great deal of uncertainty in relationship to what is going on. Personally, the only thing I'm working with right now is hope and faith. It's not about my spiritual ascension path, that is guaranteed, that is done, but it's about my material, physical life. That's quite challenging, my third and fourth dimension. And so I also wanted to thank you for all your comments, your emails, your support, your donations. All those things are very appreciated. I thank you very much. But very soon, a new level, we're going to be able to do to move into the next level. For when I ask for what about many things in ask spirit about many aspects of my life, the answer I get is like, you will see, or you will see, or it's like, but then, you know, I like to see, but it's like I'm not seeing everything right now. For there's been a very this rumor that was started long ago by a godhead named Jehovah. It was the rumor of fear. This rumor of fear has gained a lot of momentum. It's became a almighty powerful force in the world. But you cannot have fear and faith in the same time. Fear will it is like, when we fear, it's like we forget the love and light of God. We forget our origin, we forget our source. For it's like fear is an ego-based force that's reinforcing, when the ego is reinforcing the fear, and the fear is reinforcing the ego. But we can live without it, with or without ego, with or without body, the life will continue. So it's, the ego has never existed. It's a fictional character that we invented and we associate with, that's connected to those fear. For God sent you into this world to give the light and love of God into the world. For fear is a companion. It's something that we have to work every day to alleviate our fear, conscious and unconscious. It may be a companion, but it's not a friend, because it will betray us every time, and fear will generate more fear. So it's fear is a distortion. It is a disease. It is something that's very unhealthy. Fear will tell you that you have to fear everything but fear itself. For fear itself, this Sun Tzu, The Art of War, that's a great philosophical book, will teach you the only thing to fear is fear itself. Fear will make you believe to fear everything but itself. So you want to choose love. Huh? For the ego serves the fear and the soul serves love. So it's about choosing the love and choosing the soul, the connection to love. For the ego is an illusion. But many people are addicted to fear. There is this big addiction to fear, this adrenaline that's been created, and they're very comfortable with that. So we have to move out of our comfort zone in order to let go of fear. For at the end, the only thing we have when we lived our life is the memories that we have and the choices that we made. Those are the only things that are truly ours. Everything else is a passing experience. And so we want to breathe as much as possible to bring to let go. The fear comes from the stress, comes from the carbon monoxide and dioxide that is stuck within our lungs. So as we breathe, bring more oxygen into our body, we positive our whole physical body. But it's an exercise just to breathe. It's not easy. I've been a long time smoker. I know that even when I stop smoking, it's still like plaguing me, because I've accumulated years and years of toxins. And I don't even know if in this lifetime I'll be able to get rid of it all, but I'm still working on it. There is this new sciences, the spiritual sciences, that will come into the picture. For in the 18th century, there was a big confrontation between religion and science, the philosophy of the humanity and the understanding of what is true and what is beliefs. But the spiritual science is the only way to move on to the next level. It has nothing to do with religion. It's about truth. It's to recognize the source of life it's a fact. The existence of God is not a belief, it's a fact. Once you accept that as a fact, you can grow from there. And this battle is still going on, for we move into very materialistic science, and all sciences are serving mankind. Some technologies are serving and others are hindering mankind. What we seek is freedom from the matrix, individually. What we need to free ourselves from the matrix is to move into a health and connected self, plus being abundant financially. For this world, 12,000 years ago, on Atlantis, life was free, was abundance. Everybody had everything they ever needed. There was just the pursuit of wisdom and growth. But as we fall into darkness, some extraterrestrial beings that are still controlling this matrix, and they're still there, some reptilian entities. And then they have their servants that are humans, that are called the Illuminatis, or the bloodlines, or whatever. Those beings have put a hold on this matrix, and as Aristotle says, the way to entrap humanity is through through money, because I'm creating a lack. Because when you create lack, you create value. But we cannot move from a system that's money free from a system of lack. We have to shift. It will take hopefully not that long, but it will take about 200 years to completely get rid of money. But in a few decades, we should be able to move from a system of lack to a system of abundance, where everybody has enough money to feel comfortable, and at which point we will be able to let go of money. But we have to move from lack into abundance on a societal level. But in the meantime, we want to free ourselves and try to elevate ourselves above to find this to be content with simple life as well, to be not to need to have too many needs. When you have very little needs, when you're humble, you can find contentment with very little. Personally, I still hope that I'll be able to equalize, balance my life, because it's becoming, someday it's like, it feels like hell. I feel like, what am I doing here? It's like, well, I can't live like that. It's like, maybe I've done my mission. It's time for me to move on. But spirit is continuing to say, wait, you'll see. So I'm hanging on. It's all about being free from our own perception sometimes, to be able to let go of all this ego mind, this personality that's always conditioning life, to believe that life is only what we experience, for life is great potential that can be experienced. I thought I come today, I'm not in the best best disposition, but I'm still moving forward with I'm going to be working on the translation of my book. It's almost done. I've been working on that. The paintings behind me is this is part of the 9 portraits that I did of the 9 muses. This is Terpsichore. She's the muse of dance. It's got this Picasso kind of, well, not really Picasso, but he's got this, he's just maybe as eccentric of bodies, or dancing bodies, just as flexible as a Picasso. And sometimes I feel like, well, my work is not pretty enough, or some portraits are not pretty enough, they're strange. But if I looked at Dora Maar of Picasso in the 40s, I would have never want to look at those paintings. It's just too violent, too brutal. But those are not brutal, but they're I was looking at Polymnie. I'm going to show it tomorrow, the muse of eloquence, but she's got a very funny look. I don't know if I should change her. She's like so. And this is a painting of it's called the Blue Star Friends and Family. It's a cosmic painting. I will return to that later as well. And so I wanted to show this portrait of Claude Monet. I think it's pretty much finished. I'm not sure. Maybe some little details in the eyes. Maybe, but it works pretty well. And this is astrology. He was a Scorpio with Jupiter in Scorpio, and his moon between Cancer and Leo. And I'm going to sing a song. It's a French song. It went through my head. I'm going to pull one more card, and it goes like this. Retiens la nuit pour nous deux jusqu'à la fin du monde. Retiens la nuit pour nos cœurs dans sa course vagabonde. Serre-moi fort contre ton corps. Il faut qu'à l'heure des folies, le grand amour raye le jour et nous fasse oublier la vie. Retiens la nuit. Avec toi, elle paraîtra si belle. Retiens la nuit, mon amour, pour qu'elle devienne éternelle, pour le bonheur de nos deux cœurs. Arrête le temps et les heures, je t'en supplie à l'infini. Retiens la nuit. Ne me demande pas d'où me vient ma tristesse, ne me demande pas, tu ne comprendrais pas. En découvrant l'amour, je frôle la détresse, en croyant au bonheur, la peur entre mes joies. Retiens la nuit pour nous deux jusqu'à la fin du monde. Retiens la nuit pour nos cœurs dans sa course vagabonde. Serre-moi fort contre ton corps. Il faut qu'à l'heure des folies, le grand amour raye le jour et nous fasse oublier la vie. Retiens la nuit avec toi, elle paraîtra si belle. Retiens la nuit, mon amour, pour qu'elle devienne éternelle, pour le bonheur de nos deux cœurs. Arrête le temps et les heures, je t'en supplie, à l'infini, retiens la nuit. Je t'en supplie, à l'infini, retiens la nuit. Thank you. It's a song by Johnny Hallyday used to sing that. It's about this true love to hold on to time and hours and to move into this eternal now, to stay the night, to forget about all of life, to make this night eternal, to connect to this eternal now. And so I'm going to pull one more card to see the conclusion. It is about peace, so it is quite wonderful. It's about acceptance, about finding balance. It's about being at peace, being at one, having the freedom the freedom comes from inside and come from the security of love. So we need to find to make every to ask and to be in a receptive mode for all the elements of our life to be balanced and to be harmonized and to not be too much in judgment of our own choices, but to always seek to align and to see how we can improve every situation. Thank you very much. I wish you a wonderful day, and I'll talk to you later. Namaste.